AMR, or antimicrobial resistance, has reached alarming levels in most parts of the world and has now been acknowledged as a significant emerging threat to public health and food security. Different sectors have worked on initiatives dedicated to improve antibiotic use. However, we must recognize that stewardship interventions must be sustained to have a continued effect. Let's find out from Bavi's experience, what resources and strategies are necessary to successfully sustain an antibiotic stewardship program? Let me start off with a quick review of AMR. AMR happens when a microbe, which is previously susceptible to antimicrobials, develop resistance, making treatment difficult or impossible. Unfortunately, these results from improper stewardship of antimicrobials, like increased consumption of antibiotics and improper prescriptions in both humans and animals. Let's take this graph for example. A study by Albrecht and company in 2004 has identified a very strong connection between AMU and resistance development and spread. And if this has been the case, let's be terrified of Van Boeckel and company's projection of AMU. The graph shows the 2030 projected increase in livestock AMU, highlighting countries with the highest increase in antimicrobial usage. This is based on the forecast increase in demand of cheaper source of meat, which is highest in low and middle income countries. Adding to the injury is the fact that resistance develops faster than we develop antibiotics. And at the rate of how fast it is developing and spreading, we will run out of effective antimicrobials to use in the future. So imagine not being able to treat simple skin infections that eventually lead to septicemia and death. These may sound exaggerated at this point, but not in 30 years, according to experts. As of 2014, deaths due to AMR is lower than other causes of death. However, in 2050, it will blow to 10 million a year. This is equivalent to one person dying every 3 seconds if we do not act now. And the areas that will be affected the most are those in the low and middle income countries due to the growing demand for animal protein. This prompted collaborative efforts from different sectors to start doing something to help address the issue. In the Philippines, the government has already created an inter-agency committee on AMR to combat antimicrobial resistance, and there is already a national action plan to combat AMR. Legislation is one thing, however, compliance and commitment of all stakeholders is another thing. Being the second largest poultry integrator and the leading roasted chicken brand in the country, we have to be responsible stewards. Bavi acknowledges the need to act now, so the company launched different stewardship initiatives over the years. In 2018, we eliminated the use of AGVs in our feeds. We eliminated the use of CIAs as prophylaxis in our regular production system in 2019. And also in 2019, we started to strictly monitor and regulate antibiotic use by implementing the no prescription, no antibiotic withdrawal policy. We also devised a reward system to motivate our partners to be highly compliant to the program. And in 2020, we implemented our No Antibiotic Ever program to all our farms nationwide. Though the nationwide implementation was only last year, our efforts to produce NAE chicken started since 2012. Let me walk you through our NAE journey once again. We started with just a few trial farms in Laguna and Batangas from 2012 to 2015. As we gained experience and confidence, it grew to 19% in 2017 when production expanded in North Luzon, Bacolod, and CDO. In 2019, NAE was already 28% of the nationwide production volume and included more areas in the Visayas and Mindanao. And we are proud that in August 2020, NAE production was implemented in all farms nationwide. Of course, like any live operation, there are always exceptions. 1 year since the nationwide implementation, only 1% of the total production was dropped from the program because there was a need to medicate. All these initiatives improved our usage of antimicrobials without affecting our productivity. The graph shows the reduction in our total usage measured in milligram active ingredient per kilogram broiler. This includes antibiotics in drinking water and antibiotics used as AGVs. There is a marked drop starting 2017 as we were already beginning to remove AGPs that time. Usage increased during 2019 because we had to replace CIAs in our prophylactic program using an antibiotic that requires a very high dose. Using the same antibiotic as prophylaxis until August 2020, consumption dropped versus 2019 since more and more farms are converting from regular to NAE. 2021 year-to-date, we still have 0.72 mg per kilogram usage for flocks that needed treatment. However, versus 2020, usage has already dropped by 80%. In the last 4 years, from 2016 to 2021, we have reduced total antibiotic usage by 98% and reduced the use of CIAs by 99%. Comparing Babi's usage with that of countries that have strong legislations and plans for AMR, we are on par, actually even better than BPC and Denmark last 2018. This has been the trend of our intestinal integrity score for the past years. Though 2019 and 2021 have deteriorated, in both years, I2 scores are still above our internal target of 90%. Even without the use of antibiotics, gut health is still very good. Now, let's go to our farm's feed efficiency. This is the scatter graph showing each of our farm's FCRs for the year. Using one-sided t-test, we are 95% confident that NAE farms have better FCRs than our regular farms. And it's the same for Visayas. Scatter graphs showing FCRs from January to September this year. So these are all NAE. FCRs have improved versus 2020. We will not be able to get these results and sustain program without these strategies, which you see are not rocket science. The secret is going back to basics, but execution should not be less than exceptional. How the broilers will cope up with the conditions in which it leaves will depend on how excellent the care we provide them. These five domains of animal welfare serve as our guiding principles in formulating standards in husbandry, housing, health, nutrition, disease diagnosis, treatment, and prevention so that broilers are at their most comfortable during the production cycle. Comfort equals efficiency. Formulating management standards for the farm will lead you nowhere if your business partners are not compliant. So we created a system which measures the level of compliance of our contract growers. We conduct audits from pre-placement to the finishing stage to ensure the standards will be properly implemented. From all the audit forms that we have, these three are mandatory and given the highest priority because lapses during this period will not be tolerated by our broilers. If the quality of cleaning, disinfection, biosecurity, and brooding of a farm is below excellent, the chances of broilers yielding to bacterial infection and thus to antibiotic treatment is high. There are no secrets either in our animal health program. Again, just the basics. We invested more in cleaning and strictly implemented minimum biosecurity measures. We use bacteriophage and alternatives and supplements that are plant-based. One important note here is that we avoid duplication of supplements in our drinking water and in-feed program. That way, our cost is optimized. The highlights for our nutritional strategies are the use of the right enzymes and zero use of animal proteins. We are using plant-based formulations. We avoided the use of animal proteins like porcine meal because we found out that this material is contaminated with antibiotics. Since animal proteins have high nutrient density and excellent digestibility than plant proteins, we use specialized feed additives that are precursors of creatinine, the energy-storing molecule of muscles. To motivate our growers to comply with standards and company directions, they are given monetary incentives. Animal health products used as per program are given to contract growers free of charge if they do not fail the biosecurity audit and if they are not using products unapproved by the animal health group. Aside from incentives, we have formulated policies and controls to avoid the abuse of antibiotics. Growers won't be able to withdraw antibiotics from our office without the written prescription of a supervising vet. We categorize antibiotics following the European Medicine Agency categorization. Field vets are allowed to prescribe only category C and D. If category C and D antibiotics are not effective, only epidemiologists have the clearance to prescribe category B using yellow prescription. In BAVI, Category B antibiotics are likened to dangerous drugs in human medicine. That way, we have more control of dispensing of the critically important antibiotics. Meat samples are routinely collected to be sent to three different laboratories. One to our company-owned laboratory, the second to NMIS, and the third to a third-party lab. This practice also helps ensure that growers do not use antibiotics unnecessarily. Otherwise, they may be penalized or terminated for breach of contract. The success of the program also depends on the kind of business partners that we have. Growers with the right attitude and mentality, receptive, are open to suggestions and recommendations, and have high level of compliance. Growers who share the same excitement and who believe in the same cause as we do, we are happy to have found them. They have made our stewardship journey less challenging. Under different leaderships, employees have different values and culture, and therefore we acted and responded differently to situations. Now that the Feed Mill and Animal Health Group are under the same leadership, team members are more united as we share common goals. Feedback and response times are faster. Teamwork of production up to marketing and sales completes the sustainability equation. It's undeniable that at the end of the day, how profitable we are ultimately decides how we can support operation, whatever the production system we are in. So much so that we are treading the path to prudent antimicrobial use. Cost to produce is higher than the regular production system, and if the company is not profitable enough, it won't be able to sustain this production system. Before I end my presentation, let me give you these key takeaways. It's possible to get exceptional farm productivity even without antibiotic prophylaxis and AGVs. Excellent management, alternatives, supplements, policies and monitoring, and people who believe in the cause will determine the success and sustainability of the program. Despite the challenges, we are committed to continue with our antibiotic stewardship and NAE chicken production programs because we want to protect the health and welfare of our birds. We want to help safeguard the efficacy and ensure sustainable use of antibiotics. We want to improve cost efficiency. We want to produce foods that consumers love and trust. And ultimately, we want to influence the industry to join us in the fight against AMR. The first step towards solving this global problem is to create awareness. This is a call to everyone to get involved in the fight against AMR. Let us all be part of the solution.